People are alarmed by the numerous and severe human rights violations taking place in our mother country. Eritrea, today we are staging a demonstration in San Francisco to condemn the dictatorial government of Eritrea for committing these abuses, to hold the authorities responsible for the crimes so committed, and to warn them to stop forth with the evil activities. Eritrea is one of the few countries in the world that has no working constitution. Eritreans are denied the basic rights to take part in the conduct of their national affairs through freely chosen representatives. Eritreans have been denied the opportunity of universal suffrage to vote, to elect and be elected through a secret ballot at acceptable intervals. What we have in Eritrea is a totalitarian and despotic one-man rule government akin to that of North Korea. The human rights abuses in our country are well documented annually by the Amnesty International, Human Rights Watch, and many other respected humanitarian organizations. The following observations will be enough to throw light in the situations of our mother country. Amnesty International's 2010 report, quote, two-thirds of the population remain dependent on international emergency food aid. The government didn't allow opposition parties, independent civil society organizations, or unregistered faith groups and tolerated no dissent. Thousands of prisoners of conscience were held. There was no recognizable rule of law or just system, civilians or military. Detainees had no means of legal redress, and judges were unable to challenge or question arbitrary detentions or government or military actions violating human rights. Constitutional and legal protections of human rights were not respected or enforced. Human Rights Watch 2009 report, quote, Eritrea's extensive detention and torture of its citizens and its policy of prolonged military conspiracy are creating a human rights crisis and promoting increasing numbers of Eritreans to flee the country. To support the report by the Human Rights Watch, we are now witnessing the tragic plight of thousands of Eritrean refugees and asylum seekers who have been stranded in Libya, Tunisia, and Egypt's Sinai. This is an ongoing occurrence. Prominently, only a few days ago, about 325 of our compatriot refugees who were earlier forced to flee their country because of the cruel regime at home have perished in the Mediterranean Sea. These helpless refugees were attempting to flee to Europe to escape the violence of the Libyan rebellion. It's also a fact that when nearly all the nations of the world came to the rescue of their citizens, the dictatorial Eritrean regime has totally abandoned its nationals. These refugees through their fate. And their fate was, as usual, to perish in the Mediterranean Sea in an unseaworthy, rickety and overloaded boats. Yes, the abuse is getting worse by the day. In unison, we the Eritreans are saying, enough is enough. The world community should not continue to ignore what is happening in Eritrea. We want to raise public awareness about the factual tragedy of the nation and its people through demonstrations like this. The regime has desperately failed its people. It has forfeited its right to rule. We appeal to you and to all government and organizations to impose the utmost diplomatic and economic pressure on the regime of President Isaias Afwerki to hand over power to the people as soon as possible and to be replaced by the Eritrean government that will do the following immediately. One, to respect the absolute right of any individual to freedom of expression and association and to freely practice one's religion or belief without restrictions from the government or any other body. take immediate measures to stop and protect women and girls from rape and other forms of sexual violence and sexual exploitation, and to hold accountable those responsible for such crimes whenever they occur. To seize and desist arbitrary mass conscriptions and the arrest, detention, and torture of our youth. To abolish underage military recruitment and stop the use of national service conscripts as forced or slave labor for private and public enterprises. To immediately end the practice of indefinite national service and to begin a process of demobilization for those who have served for more than the legal 18 months. To immediately release all political and religious prisoners, including members of the G15 and all other detained without charge or trial. To give the free access to the ICRC, Amnesty International, Human Rights Watch, and other independent monitors to all the known and secret detention centers in the country to verify that the international norms of treatment of prisoners are respected. To remove the totalitarian system imposed on the Eritrean people against the will, and to begin the democratization process immediately. Please pass these to this on to the appropriate authorities of your organizations who can help relieve the Eritrean people from their desperate situations. Thanking in advance for the understanding and cooperation. We remain yours respectfully. The Bay Area Eritrean Committee.
Thank you.
No, dictator!